Hello, my name is Mike, and I wanted to show you how to send emails to different people based on a drop-down menu. In fact, I'll show you two different ways. Let's get started. First, I'll start with Formidable's contact form template, just so we don't waste time building a form. Then I'll drag a drop-down field to the top of the form and label it, "Who would you like to contact?" Let's add some options. Admin, marketing, sales, and support. Four common options. Okay, that's good. Let's update to save and then go to the settings of our form. Under actions and notifications, there will be a default email notification action. Let's open it up. We have some standard options here where we can enter field IDs, and our two-field defaults to the admin email. For the first method, we're going to use the conditional logic down here. We'll just change it so this action occurs if "who would you like to contact" is equal to admin. So if someone chooses admin in the dropdown, this action occurs, but otherwise it won't. Then we'll go up and add another email action, but we'll change the to field to our marketing email. And then, obviously, change the conditional logic to when they choose marketing. Easy. To complete this method, we'd do it for the other two fields as well. Okay, I'll hit update to save this, and let's go back to our form for the second method. What we're going to do now is check the Use Separate Values option for our drop-down menu. And we're going to add the email addresses for our four options. Once we've added our options, let's go back into Settings and then Actions and Notifications. I'm going to delete our second email action and delete the conditional logic in the original one, since we don't need those. Then let's go to the To field, delete what's there, and then choose the ID of the "Who would you like to contact" field. This adds the selection to our To field, but it's not adding the separate value. It's just adding the word admin or marketing. To fix that, we need to add "show equals value" in quotes inside the brackets after the ID. Now it will use the emails we put in the separate values part of the field. And in this second method, you only need the one email action. And that's it. Two simple ways to send emails based on a drop-down field. Subscribe for more WordPress and Formidable Forms tips, and I'll see you next time.